Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da. Habita fillah. It's important to never give in to our desires and let the people of evil and deception who speak ill about you based upon ignorance to cause you to despair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for you to belittle yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabihi al-kareem about the sifat al-mu'mineen qal wa'ibad al-rahman al-ladhina yamshuna ala al-ard hawnan wa'idha khatabuhum al-jahilun qalu salama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabihi al-kareem, he says, and the slaves of the most benefit are those who walk on the earth in humility. And when the foolish address them with bad words, they reply back with mild words of gentleness. Ahabati fillah, this is a sifat of ibad ar-Rahman. This is a characteristic of those slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who take the higher path. Those who take the better road. Those who take the steep path and they don't reduce themselves to their own desires to want to always respond with evil to evil. Meaning that those people who speak ill based upon ignorance, that the Ibadullah as-Salihin, the righteous, pious servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are humble. And they don't always have to respond back to those who criticize them based on evil and evil thoughts. Hadha sifat, sifat al-mu'mineen. Hadha sifa min sifat al-mu'mineen. This is the characteristics of the believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, this is a higher road. Why is this a higher path? Why is this a higher, a steeper calling? Because from our desires is the need to respond when people are speaking ill to us. And many of us from our cultures, our past cultures, and present cultures, that we look at it as a thing of status to be able to respond back to someone who is speaking about you based upon ignorance and desires and evil. And we want to respond back to them. But if you see that the righteous, that this is a characteristic that they possess, is that they're not quick to respond. That yes, they can defend their honor, that's their haq. But to always rush to defend yourself, this is not from the sifat al-mu'mineen. And we see from some of the people that if someone speaks about them, they're quick, they rush to get an army of people to try to defend them. Hadha laysa sifa min sifat al-mu'mineen. This is not from the characteristics of the mu'mineen. So we want to follow, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the ayat, and the slaves and the most beneficent are those who walk in the earth in humility. That means being humble. That means being humble in our affairs, which is also difficult for many of us. May Allah rectify our condition and bless us. Ameen. And when the foolish address them, they reply back with mild words of gentleness. And let me give you an example of Habit Allah that I've witnessed. And it's something I've witnessed with some of the Arabs, the good ones that are on Istiqamah. I've learned this because this is a part of the trait. First and foremost, it's a trait of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his followers. But what you have in the Arabic cult, in the general culture from amongst the Arabs, is that when they want to advise you, they will first address you with something good. They will first soften your heart. Then they will offer you some constructive criticism. So for example, if you see your brother make a mistake in Salat, if you see your brother utter a statement which is wrong, instead of rushing, Akhi, you messed up. Akhi, you're a mubtadi'a. Akhi, this is a statement of kufr. But instead, Ibad al-Rahman and those with the aslub al-sunnah, that have the way of addressing things, which is the way of the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they will begin with kind, gentle words to soften the heart, open the heart of the listener, so that the listener is not already repulsed by what you're speaking before you even given the nasiha. Ya akhi, my brother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve you and bless you, because we see so much good in you. But I just wanted to observe that in such and such and such and such statement, we find strangeness, or it is a statement which is not known from Ahl Islam. But my point being, Ahabati Fillah, is address it with kindness and wisdom, and have a hikmah. This is from the wisdom of putting everything in its proper place, and we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.